What is a phrasal verb? What is the meaning of a phrasal verb? Well, it's actually not that complicated. A phrasal verb is a piece of, well, it's sort of grammar in the way that it's put together, but a thing that has its own meaning. And the difficulty about phrasal verbs is that it often has several meanings. That's what makes it tough. When you watch a movie and you see someone say, "Get out!" You know what that means, but if you hear them say, "Get out somewhere else," it means something else. So, I'm confused. It's confusing because phrasal verbs have often many different meanings, okay? But they're so common, so we have to learn them. What we're going to do is go through 5 really common phrasal verbs with examples. Now, we're going to go really fast. I'm not going to very slowly explain them as I might do in one of my courses. I'm going to go through them really fast. I'm going to give you examples. I'm going to talk about the different meanings. And then, if you want to test yourself, if you think you got the right idea, make your own examples and leave them in the comments. Leave them in the comments. The best way to learn something is to practice input and output, okay? So a phrasal verb is a phrase. Most native English speakers in a language will know most of them. There are some that are special for different countries, but most native English speakers will know most phrasal verbs. And basically, it's a verb plus a preposition or a verb plus an adverb. That's how it goes. All right, so let's go through our first one. Again, we're going to go really fast, super duper fast. Try to make your own examples. Leave them in the comments. Okay, so first one, back up. Back up. All right, now, the first one, you backed up right onto my lawn. Lawn is the thing outside of your house with grass. And if you back up onto it, if you back up onto my lawn, that means you go from off of it onto it. Maybe you're in your car and you're trying to reverse and somehow you get onto the grass. Of course, I'm going to be angry if you back up onto my lawn. So when I say it, I'll say, "You backed up onto my lawn." I'm upset about this. You maybe need to fix my lawn or pay me some money, okay? If you get in trouble, I'll back you up. I'll back you up. Now, this is totally different. If you get in trouble, I'll back you up. What might this mean? Back up with a car? That can't be right. No. This one means support you. So maybe you do something in school, we're students, and you get in trouble, and I'm your best friend, and then you may be told a lie, and I lie for you to support you. I will back you up no matter what happens. I will support you. I will stand behind you. Doesn't always mean lie. Could be a good thing. If you do what you think is right and you get in trouble for it, something happens to you, I will stand behind you. I will back you up. So this is totally different. This doesn't mean we're moving backward like backing up onto a lawn. This means we're supporting someone, we're standing behind them, or we're standing with them to show that we support them, to show that maybe we're friends. Okay, what about this one? Don't forget to back up your project to the cloud. Okay, now this is, again, totally different. Now, if it's one word, sometimes you'll see this as one word. Backup will be together, back and up as one word, B-A-C-K-U-P, with no space, okay? Now this one, what could this mean? Don't forget to back up your files. Don't forget to make a backup. This is when you have maybe a project or a file on your computer, and it's only there. You want to make a copy in case something happens to your computer. What if your computer falls down and it breaks, or someone spills coffee on it and it's destroyed? The file's gone. Ah, but if you have a copy of it, a second copy of it, a backup, then there's another one there. So it's no big deal. Oh, okay. I have a backup. Don't worry about it. Well, I'm upset that my computer is broken, but I have a backup. A backup. If it's a noun like that, then we'll use a, okay? So these three meanings, one is to have a backup, copy of something, behind it, another is to support, and another is to actually move backward. All right, let's move on, moving quickly. Work out, work out. If I ever work out who stole my camera, I will take revenge. I will take revenge. If I ever work out who stole my camera, work out who? Is that anything like figure out who stole my camera? Yes, it is. So this workout is sort of like figure out or find the answer. I'm trying to work out a very, very difficult problem. It's just so tough. I've been working on it for 6 weeks and I haven't figured it out yet. If I ever work out who stole my camera, I'm going to be very upset. I don't know now. I'm trying to look at the clues and figure it out. I haven't yet. Okay, so we use workout in this way. I feel like everything always works out in the end. This is my general feeling, my overall feeling. What does that mean to work out in the end? Well, if something works out, if someone says, oh, it'll work out, everything will work out, that means it will be okay finally. Everything will be fine. We could add fine to this. We could say everything works out fine in the end. So maybe in this situation, somebody is stressed out or worried about how something might be in the end. They're maybe afraid, what if my application isn't approved or whatever? Someone might say, you know what? I think everything always works out in the end. So don't worry. That means no matter what happens, it will be okay. Everything worked out fine. So we're talking about the end result, what happened at the end. And this one is really, really common. Okay. I usually work out twice a week. Now, this is the one that you probably know. If you work out twice a week, you exercise twice a week. So when we talk about running or going to the gym and doing exercise, we often say instead of exercising, we say work out. I work out twice a week. Now, with this one, again, we can put them together. Remember what we did with backup? Backup as one word, make a backup. One word, backup. Same thing with workout. After my workout, I was exhausted. And so I had a banana and peanut butter smoothie. Okay, my workout, so that's a noun. Okay, so you can use it as a noun or two words as a verb, phrasal verb, okay? So this one just means to exercise, and often we use this for a short period of exercise, not for our whole lives. We say, I am going to go work out for an hour. Something like that, okay? So these are all, again, very common. All of these are super, super common, but we're trying to move very quickly. I'm going through these as fast as I can. I'm challenging myself. So let's move on. Next one, number three, here we go. Bring up, bring up. Now the first meaning you probably know, you must know, okay? Bring the boxes up from the lobby. If you have time, bring the boxes up from the lobby. Now the lobby is at the base, the ground floor of a building, maybe a hotel, maybe an apartment building, okay? If there are some boxes, maybe from Amazon or whatever, in the lobby, we might ask our husband or our wife or our daughter or our son or our friend, hey, can you please bring up those boxes? Bring them up. Okay, so that's very simple. They were down and now they're up. So it couldn't be simpler. But that's the basic meaning. So I'm sure you probably know that one. Now, the more complicated meaning is Grandpa always looks sad whenever someone brings up the war. Huh. Okay, so what's this one? Bring up something, to bring up a topic. Hey, don't bring that up. Maybe it's not a good idea if you bring that up. Oh, you really brought up a very good point the other day. You brought up a very good point. So is this like mention? Don't mention it? Do mention it? You mentioned something? Yes, it is. It's the same as mention. Okay, so maybe Grandpa fought in the war. He has some really bad memories from the war. Maybe he's, you know, his friends died. Terrible memories. So when someone's talking about the war, Grandpa feels sad when someone brings it up. Imagine the topics are all down here and we sort of bring them up. Okay, so we can understand that. That's pretty straightforward. Now, the third way we use this one is, I want to bring my children up to be honest and responsible. Or we could say, I was brought up by my parents to never lie, or something like that. Try to bring your children up to be decent people. So when we talk about parents raising children, parents teaching their children things, we say that parents are bringing their children up. Now, could grandparents bring children up? Could teachers? Well, if it's grandparents, maybe. If the parents aren't really there, or the child lives with the grandparents all the time, it's really the people that the children spends time with at home. These are the people who bring up the child. And we wouldn't say teachers do that because children don't live with teachers. It could be grandparents, though, if the parents maybe aren't there or whatever happens. For example, Spider-Man. Spider-Man, Peter Parker, was brought up by his aunt because his parents died and his uncle died. So he was brought up by his aunt. Okay, this one is very common. So hopefully all of these are pretty clear. Again, these are all super, super common, but we must move on. We're going very quickly here. So let's go to the next one. Look up. Now, the first meaning, very, very, very simple. We like to look up at the stars on warm summer nights. This one is so simple. That just means we do this. We lay maybe in the grass and we look up at the sky. Very basic. We look up. We look up. Okay. But the second one is kind of related to this, except it's not actually physically happening. There's a relationship, but it's not literal. So let's look at the second one. Oh, wait, what happened? I look up to people who do what they think is right no matter what. Huh. Well, what does that mean? I look up to people who do what they think is right no matter what. Could that be admire? Yes, it could. So we look up to people. That means that we admire them. Now, we don't actually look up to them, right? Maybe they're not actually taller than us or standing on a mountain or something. But in a way, we think they're great. We like their characteristics. Does it have to be a certain person? No. It could be a kind of person. I look up to people who do this. That's a general characteristic that I look up to. If anybody has that characteristic, I will admire them. I will respect them for that thing, maybe not other things. But we could say a specific thing, a specific person. I mean, we could say, I really look up to my brother. He's so wise and intelligent. Okay, you look up to your brother. You admire your brother. Now, is this the same as respect? Maybe not. Respect is often something that we show with our actions. We should show respect in public with people, right? And maybe in our minds we're going, I don't actually care. I don't care at all. So we respect them with our actions socially, but we might not admire them, but admire and look up to. These are things that are on the, see, I'm touching my chest. That means it's real. It's real. It happens inside. So admire and look up to are the same thing. Okay. Next one. Before the internet, it used to take forever to look things up. To look things up. To look things up. What does that mean? Well, when we want to look something up, we have something specific in mind and we want to find out what it means or we want to understand more about it. Now, this does not mean just casually looking through some books. If we're not searching for something, we're not looking it up. First, we have an idea. I want to know more about the Himalaya Mountains. I want to know the definition of the word hermeneutics. Okay, now I'm going to find that information. I'm going to go and I'm going to search it. I'm going to look it up. General learning, what you're doing right now, for example, watching this, you're not looking things up, just watching me. Okay, but if you have something you want to know and you know what that is, then you can say you're looking it up. Of course, it's much faster to do that when we have the internet, right? So it's faster to do it now that we have the internet than it was when we didn't, when we had to go to the library and take some books out and look through the books. Very slow, of course. Okay, 4 out of 5. We have one more to do. Okay, one more. The last one we're going to talk about is run out. There are two very common ways to use run out. Okay, one meaning of run out is to actually leave the house and go do something. Like, I ran out to grab some milk and eggs for the cake I was making. So I'm making a cake, and then I realize, no, I don't have milk and eggs. Now, I don't know why I would be so stupid to start making a cake if I didn't have the two most important ingredients. But hey, it's just an example. Anyway, does it actually mean that I ran? Did I physically run to the supermarket? No. If I say, I'm going to run out to the supermarket, I'm going to run over to Carl's house, I'm going to run to the library, it doesn't mean that we're running over there. Not really. Maybe, but probably not. Generally, it just means we're going to go there pretty quickly and come back, where we're going to go there and not stay for a long time. We wouldn't say I'm going to run over to some place and stay for 9 hours. We usually, if we're going to run an errand or we're going to get something we need, we go there, we buy it, we get it, we take it, and then we come back. So we run out to get something. We run out to do something. That's why we use run in this way. Okay, now what about the last one? If you ever run out of ideas, just let me know. I have a million. Okay, now this one is about quantity, how much of something we have. You could say, we ran out of milk. We ran out of sugar. I need to run out to get something. Those are two different meanings of run out. First one, we ran out of milk, means there was milk and then duck, 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 duck. Now it's gone. We had it before and we ran out. You can't use ran out if you didn't have it before. You have to have it and then it goes down until there's none. Then you can say, we ran out of this. Then you can run out to get more. Two different meanings. Okay, so if someone says, I ran out of ideas, trying to think of a good idea, maybe you're trying to solve a problem or write a story or whatever, I want to let my friend know, if you ever run out of ideas, you feel like you had many ideas and now you have none, let me know. Maybe I can give you some good ideas. Okay, so these are the ways that we use these phrasal verbs. All of them are very common. All of them are very useful. I would really like if you could try to make your own examples. Make your own examples, okay? I know we went very quickly. If something is unclear, ask in the comments. If you want me to check your examples or look at them, leave them in the comments, okay? And by the way, don't forget to hit the like button and also subscribe if you haven't already.